Hello, my name is Paul Brohlin. I lead the development of GaN products at Texas Instruments. And today I am excited to have Dr. Marvin Tannhäuser with us, a power supply expert and a member of corporate technology at Siemens. Welcome, Marvin.
Hi, Paul, and thanks for the introduction.
Before we start today, can you tell us a little bit about what your team does and what its mission and vision is?
Of course, sure. So we at Siemens Corporate Technology investigate novel key technologies like GaN to ensure future businesses of the company. And my research group develops advanced power electronics, and we consider the GaN technology on a power electronic system level. And we see, especially for grid-connected power converters, the fast and efficient switching speed of GaN gives us some advantages for applications like photovoltaic, energy storage, or power supplies.
So in respect to power supply density and efficiency, can you explain the major challenges faced in designing grid-connected power systems?
So I think in a grid-connected power converter, most of the volume is used for the passive components and the cooling. With GaN, we can design very efficient power converters, which will help to shrink the cooling components. The fast switching speed allows us to use higher switching frequencies in the system, which will reduce the size of the power inductor.
So can you explain how, when you increase the switching speed with GaN, you can reduce the size of the power inductors?
Of course. So I think the example for the power inductor is quite simple. If we double the switching frequency, we can reduce the inductance by a factor of 2. And this will help to use smaller and cheaper components. In addition, a smaller passive components will allow as well an easier and automated manufacturing. On the other hand, a fast switching speed causes higher EMC emission. And I mean, in general, if you have higher switching frequencies, you need a higher damping in this EMC filter. And to have finally a very good EMC solution, you need to consider the whole concept and the whole design from the beginning.
For years, the evolution of GaN has been very exciting to power supply design engineers. How have these changes in GaN affected the development of grid-connected power converters?
Okay. So to make the GaN technology available and usable for the power electronics engineers, and to see that all vendors offer new devices with higher reliability and lower on resistance. With these efficient devices, we can develop PCB-based multilevel converters in a power range of several kilowatts without using any kind of power modules. And I mean, replacing the power module with the SMD devices gives us some further advantages for the manufacturing. On the other hand, we have to handle the power losses in a different way. We cannot just simply attach a heatsink to the base plate of a power module. And this means we need suitable and high-performance SMD packages, and as well a good concept for the thermal design of the PCB, finally.
When you think of GaN, most power supply design engineers think of single phase with 300 volt to 400 volt bus voltages. How can you use GaN in a grid-connected power converter at much higher bus voltages?
Okay, so if you want to go to higher voltages and three-phase systems with a 600 volt device, you must consider multi-level topologies. They are a little bit more complex than classical two-level converters, but they have a reduced switching voltage, which brings you a more efficient switching. And the lower switching voltage also allows you to reduce the inductance again. And I think all these benefits together will enable you to design power converters with a higher power density and lower costs, finally.
So we are demoing this power supply at APEC 2018. Can you tell us how this power supply works?
Of course. So the setup consists of actually two bidirectional DC to AC converters in a back-to-back configuration circulating 5 kilowatt of power. With this setup, we can show grid voltage and power levels at the booth. And the typical voltage in a three-phase system is 400 volt on the line-to-line side and 650 on the DC link. To handle these voltages, we used TI daughter card and designed a three-level topologies. On the daughter card, we have the LMG3410, which is a 600 volt, 70 milliohm GaN devices in a SMD package. And I think it's a very interesting demonstrator to show what you can do with GaN. I mean, it's a three-phase converter built with SMD devices, which can deliver up to 8 kilowatt of power. It operates with a switching frequency of 150 kilohertz and reaches efficiency of up to 99%.
So can you give us some examples of products and applications that you can use this three-level grid-connected converter in?
So, I mean, in general, all applications where you have to exchange electrical energy with the grid, for example, photovoltaic. But you can also consider the strong growing markets for battery storage or e-car charger. And I think the setup already has shown the bidirectional energy flow, which is needed for these applications.
Thank you, Dr. Tannhäuser, for your perspective and advice of how to use GaN and multi-level grid-connected converters. And to start your power supply today with GaN, please visit ti.com/GaN.